Two key Republican lawmakers who requested access to classified information about a confidential FBI source are set to meet with senior Justice Department and FBI and intelligence officials tomorrow to see this info. Now, not invited, as far as we know, to the meeting are any Democrats. So let's talk to a Democrat from the House Intel Committee, Texas Congressman Joaquin Castro. Good morning, Congressman.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Have you asked whether you can go to this meeting?
Well, it's basic protocol that when you have these kinds of meetings on the Intelligence Committee, that you have both Republicans and Democrats represented. So this very much is a departure from standard operating procedure, and it makes it seem more like a Trump legal defense team meeting than anything else.
Have you told your chairman, Devin Nunes, by the way, I would like to go?
I believe that basically our ranking member and our staff have communicated by this point the fact that Democrats should be included, sure. But also, that's something that Devin knows. He knows that it's standard procedure for both sides to go.
Well, that's not what the White House knows. Here's what Press Secretary Sarah Sanders claims about that invitation.
Would the White House welcome Democrats to be at that meeting?
We'll keep you posted. My understanding is they haven't been the ones requesting this information. So I would refer you back to them on why they would consider themselves randomly invited to see something they've never asked to.
Why would you consider yourself randomly invited, Congressman?
Again, that's a nonsensical answer. This is information that basically is part of the investigation, and it's significant information. So why, if there is significant information, would you not include the relevant folks who were involved in the investigation?
So just one last question on this thread. If you went up to Devin Nunes today and said, I would like to come, what would happen?
Well, we'll see. I promise you today that I'll go up to Devin Nunes and ask him to invite everybody on the committee.
Are you concerned that the FBI and the DOJ are opening their files and revealing an informant's name to members of your committee?
Yeah, there are a few concerns. First, that this person's life could be affected, obviously could be endangered. There's a reason that sources are kept very confidential and classified. But the other thing is that there's this parlor game that's going on. Basically, Devin Nunes, who is now part of Donald Trump's legal defense team, is requesting information from executive agencies, getting that information, and then most likely going over and sharing it with the president or his team so that he can handicap his legal liability. In other words, so that he can better assess whether he should do something like testify in front of the grand jury. So there is this channel of information that I think is going from the executive agencies to Devin Nunes over to the White House.
So that's what you think this is about. You don't think that
Sure. This
is about investigating. You think it's about feeding information to the White House. Why?
I think it's been about feeding information to the White House for a long time. And we've seen that. We saw that with the midnight run months and months ago. It's the same racket that's been going on.
So you think that, I mean, what you're saying, basically, is that Devin Nunes is an instrument of President Trump's defense and his sullying of the criminal justice system and the Department of Justice.
Yeah, unfortunately, Congressman Nunes, Chairman Nunes, has played that role now for a while. I don't know exactly why or when he decided to do that, but it's clear that he's been doing that for a while.
And so why do you think, in that case, the FBI Director, Chris Wray, and the Director of National Intelligence, Dan Coats, are going along with opening these files and revealing a confidential informant's name?
That's a great question, and I hope that you put that question to them directly. I don't understand, first of all, why they're going along with a meeting that they understand is a break from standard procedure that everybody that's relevant to this investigation, in other words, the investigators, should all be present for this, even if it's not the larger Intelligence Committee, even if it's just the so-called Gang of Eight, which would include our ranking member, Adam Schiff. Everybody who's a relevant investigator should be there. So I was kind of surprised to see that the FBI and the DOJ would go along with this. You know, I described that back channel of information. Where the executive agencies fit in is, I don't think they're actively necessarily, in cahoots with Devin Nunes to help him out, to give information to the president. But I do think that in order to save their jobs, they are capitulating, they're acquiescing to all of Devin Nunes's requests. And so they eventually cave in, they give him the information he wants, and then he finds a way to feed it to the president. The president's able to handicap or figure out some better legal strategy because of the information he has, and they keep doing this over and over.
From what you've learned, do you think the FBI did anything wrong by using a confidential informant or source to try to talk to George Papadopoulos or Carter Page or Sam Clovis?
Well, I guess let me say this. In all of the information that I've seen as somebody who's been on this intelligence committee doing this investigation now for over a year, I did not see anybody who served as a spy in the Trump campaign.
So can you say that again? You didn't think that who served as a spy?
I didn't see any indication that anybody was serving as a spy.
But did you know about this confidential informant?
There's some stuff that is classified, obviously, that I can't discuss. But in reviewing everything and everything that was presented to us, no, there was no indication that anybody was a spy. In fact, I think yesterday, Carter Page, who was part of the Trump campaign, basically said that based on his interactions, he had no indication that anybody was spying on the campaign.
Yeah, Sam Clovis has virtually said something quite similar. So what does Congress do about this, that the president is tweeting this morning that this could be the biggest scandal in history?
Well, I mean, that's the president's MO, right? The president is basically blows things up, exaggerates things, and he tries to dominate the narrative that way. That's what he does. It doesn't make it true. In fact, in Washington, he's probably the person that tells, quite honestly, the most lies of any politician out there. So this is consistent with what he does.
That's what fact checkers who've crunched the numbers say in terms of the staggering number of untruths that come out of the president. Congressman Joaquin Castro, thank you very much for your perspective. Please let us know what response you get when you talk to your chairman, Devin Nunes, about going to this meeting.
I will.
Thank you.